Today's day is very important and it's of utmost essence. Myself, as a science educator and education person, I've been to some of these schools. I grew up in a very rural area where I've never seen a test tube. I've never seen a microscope. I came across those things for the first time at the varsity level. Now, a lot of people think Gauteng is actually a rich province. It's not correct. I've been around some of the schools here and I've realized that the lack of facilities that they have. So for us today, it's a day to celebrate the opportunity that we are bringing to the young ones, not like us, that they'll have an opportunity to now use the thing, touch and do the practicals. So for me, that's passion. It's touchy. I feel like crying, in fact, that we're going to change a lot of lives of these young children. Unlike us, they'll have an opportunity to touch and do experiments by themselves, to learn and not memorize. Some of us, we grew in memorization and not apply, but these kids are going to get an opportunity to do all of those things. And with this launch like this one today, this facility, as I said, I wanted to touch not less than 40 schools in Gauteng. I really want that 40 schools because I know out of that 40 schools will change the lives of many children. That we want engineers, technicians, medical doctors, all those people, technologists will come out of this facility here. Now, the target of our schools is that what we know in the schools of Gauteng, you know, many people don't know Gauteng has got rural schools. There are rural schools in Midrand area, in that side of Hammanskraal, in Brits, in that side of Krugersdorp, somewhere in Sebokeng. So we are targeting previously disadvantaged schools. But importantly, not just township schools, we are targeting schools that are sitting in the rural areas. Those are the schools like the one that you saw today, I think that Lesania Primary School. That school comes from a rural place. Their school is dilapidated, it's heartbreaking. So these are the kinds of things we're going to target. So our focus is on those people that don't have access and opportunity for these kinds of things. So we'll be targeting those schools without excuse, without any sort to anyone. We are going after the rural schools, going after the township schools, going after those schools that don't have the mobile labs, that don't have the laboratories with them. That's the population we're going to serve.
Perhaps what I can say is that the mobile lab is part of a broader program around science, technology and maths, what we call STEM. So at SASOL we run various programs. We've got bursaries and internships, we've got vocational training, and we also have learner support in the form of material and equipment. So the mobile labs form part of the program of material and equipment that helps to capacitate children in the field of maths, science, technology and engineering. So today, the main purpose of today was to provide the mobile lab to be able to reach far-flung schools in the rural areas particularly, because we find that's where the greatest need is. And the reason why we choose a mobile lab is that it can touch plenty of schools. It's not static, it's not in one area. You can actually make sure that it reaches a greater number of needs compared if you had just built it in one area. So our approach is that for as long as there's a need and we're able to respond, then we will provide a mobile lab just like we would provide a mobile clinic, because it can reach a greater, broader need or audience compared to what you would do with a static structure.
For more stories like these, go to www.social-tv.co.za. Subscribe to us on YouTube and follow us on our social mediums.